हेलो स्टूडेंट, वेलकम बैक टू आवर प्रैक्टिकल कोर्स CHO 5306, दैट इज़ डबल एंड मल्टीपल स्टेज सिंथेसिस। फ्रेंड्स, इन माय लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैव कवर्ड वन एक्सपेरिमेंट। नाउ इन दिस लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू कवर अनदर एक्सपेरिमेंट एंड इज टाइटल्ड एज हाइड्रोक्विनोन टू हाइड्रोक्विनोन डायस्टेट टू 2,5-dihydroxyacetophenone। सो फ्रेंड्स, this is the two step synthesis and first step is hydroquinone to hydroquinone diacetate and then after that we are going to convert hydroquinone diacetate to 2,5-dihydroxyacetophenone. So let's begin with this experiment. This is the reaction for this experiment. So this is a hydroquinone. Friends, most of time you are confused with hydroquinone and benzoquinone. So hydroquinone and benzoquinone are the same compounds, just the name are similar, so don't confuse with the name. So we have this hydroquinone, and when we treat it with the acetic anhydride, it forms diacetate compound like this. Both the OH group, phenolic OH group, are acylated with the acetic anhydride, and then heating in presence of AlCl3 will convert this diacetate compound into dihydroxyacetophenone compound. Okay, this is the name reaction. I hope you remember the Fry's rearrangement. So this is nothing but Fry's rearrangement reaction. So let's see what is the practical procedure for this reaction. For the stage 1, we need to add a single drop of estersopril. This one is catalyst for our reaction to a mixture of 1 gram of given compound, that is hydroquinone, and 1.7 ml of acetic anhydride in a dry 25 ml conical flask. So what we have taken? We have taken hydroquinone 1 gram, 1.7 ml acetic anhydride, and a single acid catalyst drop of concentrated estersopril. Now we need to stir that flask gently by hand. This mixture will warm up rapidly as it is an exothermic reaction, and the given compound hydroquinone is dissolved. After 5 minutes, we need to check the TLC. If the complete reaction is occurred, then we need to pour this solution into 20 ml of crushed ice. As if we pour the mixture on the crushed ice, the organic compound will be precipitated out. We need to filter it and wash it with water. As you know that acetic acid or acetic anhydride is easily washed with the water, we should wash it with the water to free it from the acetic acid or acetic anhydride. So we need to crystallize from 50% ethanol, and we need to report the melting point, TLC and yield of this first stage product. Now this first stage is completed. Now we need to dry the compound very well, and we need to dry the apparatus also, because in the next stage we are going to use the AlCl3. Okay, so AlCl3 is very sensitive to water, I will say moisture sensitive compound. It reacts violently with water, so our product as well as glassware must be dried very well. So friends, what we need to do, we need to powder our compound, first stage compound, that is diacetate compound, 0.5 gram and 1.08 gram of anhydrous AlCl3, and we need to put it in a round bottom flask, 25 ml, fitted with air condition, and after that we need to put a guard tube filled with calcium chloride. That's why the AlCl3 is protected from the moisture. So now the setup is ready. Now we need to heat these flasks for around temperature 110 to 120 degree for 30 minutes. Okay, now reaction will initiate, and this initiation of reaction will be confirmed by evolution of HCl gas. Once the evolution of HCl gas begins, we can raise the temperature up to 160 to 165 degrees Celsius, and we need to maintain this temperature for next 3 hours. Okay, if we maintain this temperature for 3 hours, then reaction will be completed. We need to check the TLC before we go for the workup. Now friends, as TLC shows the completion of reaction, we need to quench the AlCl3 by adding water and HCl. So you need to add crushed ice because it is exothermic reaction. Don't worry, the quantity of AlCl3 is very small, so you can carefully add 4-5 gram of crushed ice and 20 ml of concentrated acid, concentrated HCl, to quench or decompose the excess of AlCl3. Now we need to filter the product obtained, that is our 2,5-dihydroxyacetophenone. We need to wash it with water and then recrystallize by 5 ml of 95% of ethanol. After second stage, we need to report the melting point TLC and yield to the supervisor. So this is the result table of our experiment. For the stage 1, you need to report physical constant, that is melting point. Similarly for the stage 2, and yield, you need to just mention the practical yield. So don't forget to mention the practical yield of stage 1, because you are using that one for the stage 2. So you need to mention the yields and then TLC, especially the RF values of reactant and product and solvent used for the TLC. Also you can mention the solvent used for the recrystallization, that is 50% ethanol for stage 1 and 95% of ethanol for stage 2. So this is all about our fourth experiment, that is conversion of hydroquinone to hydroquinone diacetate and hydroquinone diacetate to 2,5-dihydroxyacetophenone. So if you guys have any doubt for this experiment, feel free to ask me. Thank you.